Today in the news, we've got some Nvidia, some more Nvidia, and some Google. What's up, guys? I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with Nvidia. Their MX130 and MX150 GPUs for notebooks were released 2 years ago and will finally be replaced. These GPUs were about as powerful as a GT 1030, but were a pretty good addition in notebooks for light gaming and productivity. Eber did a video on the subject a few days ago, so I would recommend checking it out if you have time. The new chips are called the MX230 and MX250. The reason I want to talk about this is because Nvidia's performance comparisons are all over the place. It's almost like the MX250 is slower than its predecessor. On Nvidia's website, the MX150 is supposed to be 4 times the performance compared to Intel's integrated graphics, the UHD 620. The MX250, though, claims it's 3.5 times faster than the same Intel IGP. So did the card get a downgrade, or did Intel's UHD graphics suddenly get better? Anyways, I don't really know, but personally, if I wanted to buy a laptop with integrated graphics or with a super entry-level GPU, I'd probably go with a Zen-based APU instead. Sticking with Nvidia, it looks like we have a little more info on the GTX 1650. Apparently, it will sport a TU117 chip instead of the TU116 in the 1660 Ti. The memory is said to be 4 GB of GDDR6 with a base clock of 1485 MHz. This is supposed to be the first next-gen card that doesn't need a PCIe power connector, since the TDP is apparently 75 watts. Just like the 1050 though, some models might need the extra power, but this will likely be on custom AIB cards. The price of this budget card is rumored to be between $150 and $200, replacing the price point of the 1050 Ti and the 1060 3GB. Personally, I have no clue where this card will fall in terms of replacements. I truly hope that it will deliver 1060 performance, but I'm not so sure about that since the 1660 Ti is supposed to equate the 1070 and the 1660 the 1060. Anyways, if all the rumors are correct, the unveiling of the 1660 Ti should happen today, and the 1650 is supposed to be released next month. Moving on, Google just sent out some invites to their GDC keynote next month. Their yearly appearance is usually based on delivering tools for game developers or talking about Android gaming, but this year it might be different. With their focus on cloud gaming last year and the introduction of their Project Stream, I think Google might unveil their plans for the Project Yeti at GDC. Project Yeti is apparently a subscription-based gaming service, and according to Kotaku, will be paired with some hardware. With the testing of Assassin's Creed Odyssey last year, we know that their services will be able to play AAA games at 1080p 60fps without any trouble. So is that potential Yeti hardware just another Android box? Here's why I really don't like what is coming. With Xbox potentially doing the same thing with their Scarlet console and their xCloud service, and even Amazon working on something similar, the only differentiating factor will be the games. So Google will buy some game studios, and so will Amazon, and this will end up with us having multiple services to play games. Just having to install Origin to play Apex Legends was a frustrating experience for me, so I can't imagine having to deal with all that is coming. What are your thoughts on this? Let me know down below. Anyways, that is pretty much it for the news today, guys. Hopefully you've enjoyed. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, and I'll see you guys next week, I think. All right? Take care.